He's alive.
He's alive. And I know where he is.
Eric was quite serious that he wanted to meet Mr. Nagase in order to kill him. And you can't explain to somebody in that situation that really it wouldn't do yourself any good to do that, never mind about the poor man involved. He was beyond reach at that point.
Eric?
You don't go through an experience like that and change as a person. And I always felt that Colin carries that great sense of humanity with him, which is, you know, why I thought Colin would be ideal for that role.
So it was something that would go around and round in your mind?
Yes.
He and Eric, seeing them in the room together, it was astounding. And the way in which he relates to Eric, I mean, he has taken on so many of the traits of Eric that it was like eerie. And that was a great thing for me because I could throw things at Colin and say, what do you think? And he would run with them.
I liked him enormously, and I think that took things up a few notches in terms of my emotional investment. This became not just a very interesting story about a character for whom I felt affection on the page. It started to feel like it became more personal.
I did not expect you to be alive.
No, of course you didn't. She thought you'd got away with it. Why are you alive? You were a war criminal. Why didn't they hang you?
Not a war criminal. Just an interpreter.
You were Kanpatai, you knew everything!